Alright, hey guys, Cole here. Welcome back to the video. So, I'm a little bit late on this video, I know. Some of you guys are gonna know that I'm a little bit late if you guys are up to date on Fortnite porting related things. So, if you guys remember the original Fortnite porting that lets you port Fortnite skins in about a second, well, we have that again, and now it is its own app. So, today I'm showing that. This came out about a week ago, but I'm late as usual. So, before I get into this, I just want to say I didn't make this, Half made this. His link will be in the description, and his Discord will be in the description. So the first thing you want to do is hover the first link in the description, and that'll take you to his Discord. So inside of his Discord, you want to head over to Fortnite Porting 2.0, and then beta download. Here, you want to just download this .zip here. It's going to say potential dangerous download just because the file isn't downloaded often, and then you just want to press continue to download. Once downloaded, you'll have this file right here. This is going to be a zip file. You can open this with whatever zip file extractor you have. You can even use the default Windows one if you want, but nobody uses that. So for this first file, we're going to be using this as a Blender add-on. So go ahead and open up Blender. In here, we're going to go to Edit, Preferences, and then add-ons, and then you want to press install and locate that file. Once you've installed it, go ahead and search Fortnite and make sure this is checked, and then you can close out of this. Now with that second file, I already have it pinned to my start menu, so just open up that exe and load up this. Give it a little bit to load here. And here we are inside of the new Fortnite porting. So this is what it looks like. It is in beta, like I said, so it's not perfect right now. So let's get into using it. So you're not actually gonna have to do anything in Blender. For the original Fortnite porting, we had to have a whole thing over here. We had to input all this stuff, choose a bunch of settings. No, in this, all we have to do is click on a skin of our choice. I'll just do this one because this actually looks cool. And then what I recommend doing is pressing options and then turning on merge skeletons as well as reorient bones. That makes it a lot better. Then you can close out of that and then press send to Blender. Wait for it. There it is. So here's our model, fully textured. Ooh, geez. Oh my gosh. So here's our model, fully textured, bones already connected, duplicate bones deleted, and yeah, it is ready to be posed and used for a render. There are a few limitations to this app. This app is not perfect. One of the biggest things is it cannot port cel-shaded skins. This is a cel-shaded skin, for example. This is another cel-shaded skin. These types of skins cannot be ported with Fortnite porting. That has to be done manually at the moment. We don't know if they're going to get an update for this, but for now, you have to do that manually, which I'll be coming out with a tutorial on at some point. But yeah, pretty much any basic skin, as long as it doesn't have a bunch of effects and cell shading and all that, you will be able to port it almost instantly. Now, there is a small chance that it can mess up on certain things. For example, here's a skin that I know it's going to mess up on. If we select this style, it will mess up on importing this style. Not sure why this happens, and it's not something I can fix, but it means you will have to do some texturing and some importing manually, most likely. As you can see, this hood thing is not textured. I don't even know if it's meant to be here, because I don't actually know the skin, but from what I can see, this is not this. So there are a few issues which involve some manual porting, which I have shown before in other tutorials. So if your skin does do this, just go ahead and manually port it. It'll take like 10 minutes. Now, not only can this thing do skins, but it's also got back blings, pickaxes, gliders, weapons. This is one of the most useful things ever. Weapons is so handy because finding weapons in U-Model is a pain. I don't know if you guys have ever tried to do it, but it is miserable. I'm not even joking. So we can just click on any weapon here. Let's do this. This looks cool. I don't know what it is, but that looks awesome. Press send to Blender. And you might have noticed it did say there's a little error there. I don't know what that's for because it imports correctly. It does import correctly, but for some reason it gives an error. And look at that. Instantly. I can go to any gun over here. I know I'm like making this sound really amazing because it is. It seriously is. I've been needing something like this for so long because finding guns in U-Model is so miserable. It takes so much longer than it should. Look at this. It's great. Oh, that's actually super cool. Oh, what the heck? That's awesome. Now, the only thing that doesn't really work in this is the emotes area. If we try to import emote onto this guy, for example, this, press send to Blender, it will give us an error. So yeah. That is Fortnite porting. If you guys need any help with this, I do recommend asking Half in his server because I'm not the developer of this and I don't know the answers to all your questions related to this. So if you do need help, you can go to me and I can try. But if I don't know what I'm doing, you probably want to go to Half. So if this video helped you, please do like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.